your life.
Yes. See anybody over here yet?
Peggy, it's here. Jess.
Hi, Peggy.
Just Metzmeyer. Family thing.
Hi, Metzmeyers.
Peggy said, oh, we're outside today. Jesse Unsley.
Yes, we are outside today in beautiful Wabash, Indiana. All right, here comes our prelude. All hail the power of Jesus' name, one of my favorite hymns. Good morning, Redeemer. It's good to be with you. And as you can see, we're outside today in a little different twist in God's creation as we celebrate the ascension of Jesus Christ into heaven. Ascension shouldn't be overlooked. It's a very happy ending to Jesus' ministry on earth as he promises the imminent arrival of the Holy Spirit, his Spirit, and then sends out his disciples to the ends of the earth as witnesses to his resurrection. He promises that he will always be with us, even until the very end of the age. And so today we remember Jesus' earthly ministry as we bask in the promise of his presence. Once again, as always, please, if you have prayer requests that you would like us to include in the service at prayer time, please make sure you start sending them in now so that we have them when that time of the service comes. Having said that, we make our beginning this morning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, Jesus sent us out to the ends of the earth with the gospel, and he promised to always be with us. Embolden us to spread the good news of his suffering, death, resurrection, ascension, and return in glory. We pray in the name of our ascended Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us join together now as we confess our sin and our sinfulness in the common confession. Most merciful God, we confess to you that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbor as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. My dear friends, Almighty God in his mercy has given his Son to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. Therefore, as a called and ordained servant of the word, I announce the grace of God unto you, and the forgiveness of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our first reading today comes from the book of Acts, the first chapter, in fact, the beginning of the book of Acts, verses 1 through 14, the story of Jesus' ascension. In my former book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus began to do and teach until the day he was taken up to heaven after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles he had chosen. After his suffering, he showed himself to these men and gave many convincing proofs that he was alive. He appeared to them over a period of 40 days and spoke about the kingdom of God. On one occasion, while he was eating with them, he gave them this command: "Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you have heard me speak about. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." So when they met together, they asked him, "Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel?" He said to them, "It is not for you to know the time or the dates the Father has set by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth." After he had said this, he was taken up before their very eyes, and a cloud hid him from their sight. They were looking intently up into the sky as he was going, when suddenly two men dressed in white stood beside them. "Men of Galilee," they said, "why do you stand here looking into the sky? This same Jesus who has been taken from you into heaven will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven." Then they returned to Jerusalem from the hill called the Mount of Olives, a Sabbath day walk from the city. When they arrived, they went upstairs to the room where they were staying. Those present were Peter, John, James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James son of Alphaeus, and Simon the Zealot, and Judas son of James. They all joined together constantly in prayer, along with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brothers. This is the word of the Lord. And our gospel reading today is recorded in the 24th chapter of Luke, beginning at verse 44, where we once again hear the story of Jesus ascending into heaven. Jesus said to them, "This is what I told you while I was still with you. Everything must be fulfilled that is written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms." Then he opened their minds so they could understand the scriptures. He told them, "This is what is written. The Christ will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and repentance and forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all nations beginning at Jerusalem. You are my witnesses of these things. I am going to send you what my Father has promised. But stay in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." And when he had led them out to the vicinity of Bethany, he lifted up his hands and blessed them. And while he was blessing them, he left them and was taken up into heaven. Then they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy. And they stayed continually at the temple, praising God. This is the gospel of our Lord. Thanks be to God. I would invite the children to please gather around now as we think about the story that we just heard from Luke, as we talk about this story of Jesus' ascension. I have something I'd like to show you today. This is a paperclip. And I can make it ascend up this rubber band. That's pretty good, huh? Up and up and up it goes. The paper clip is ascending into heaven, ascending up the rubber band. There we go. There we go, up, up, and away. What do you think about that? Is that pretty cool, or is what? Is that something that surprised you? Does it surprise you that your pastor can make a rubber band climb up, or a paperclip climb up a rubber band? It surprises me if it doesn't surprise you. Does it surprise you enough that it's something you want to talk about? Maybe tell your friends about? Hey, my pastor made a paperclip crawl up a rubber band today. You think that's something you'd like to tell your friends? Something you'd like to share with your neighbors? Well, I don't know if it was that impressive that you want to go out and share that with your friends and neighbors. But the story we just heard about Jesus ascending into heaven is something that we certainly want to share with our friends and with our neighbors. Just as the apostles did when they were looking up into heaven and they were amazed that Jesus had just lifted up into the clouds and disappeared from them. But there's also something exciting about that too. Two angels appeared and said, "Men of Galilee," or disciples, or James and Luke and Kennedy and Reagan and Brindley and Noah and Molly and Daisy and Sydney and Spencer and Ari and Alyssa, Jesus will return the same way he came. But this time he will return in power and glory and majesty. And that's something we want to remember. And that's something we want to tell our friends and our neighbors about. Jesus came. Jesus died. Jesus rose. Jesus ascended into heaven. And Jesus is coming back to take us to be with him forever in the mansions of glory. God bless you all. Thank you for being with us. And thank you for sharing this great news, this good news about Jesus' ascension with your friends and with your neighbors. Let us pray. Dear Father, thank you for sending Jesus. Thank you for letting the disciples see him ascend into heaven. And thank you for the promise that he's coming back to take us to be with him, to take us to be with you in the mansions of glory. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. As we think about that, I'd like to, for us to share and listen to the song, I Love to Tell the story about Jesus. Are we there yet? Have you ever asked that question? Have you ever been asked that question? I know I have. Are we there yet, Mom? Are we there yet, Dad? When are the face masks? When are the constant hand washing? When's the social distancing and all the rest of this stuff? When's it going to go away? See, we never stop asking that question. Are we there yet? Or at least we never should. Because it means that our heart's still in it. It tells us that hope is still there. And we can't live without hope. Are we there yet? Maybe not, but at least we know that we're still here. You see, ascension is an are we there yet time. When Jesus rose into heaven, the apostles were standing there looking up into the sky. And they were asking, are we there yet? Their minds were asking the question that their mouths weren't able to. And Jesus wanted them to ask that question. That's why he's went. So that we could hear the answer. He will come back in the same way that he came. In the same way that you saw him go into heaven. And that question still rattles around. That question still rattles us. Are we there yet? How long? That question rattles from the weight of an emotional disorder or from the crushing confinement of a psychological torture. A lonely person crying out, how long? Maybe they're depressed, or maybe they're obsessed, or addicted, or self-destructive. But they want to know, how long, O Lord? How long? That question rattles in the hospital room among monitor blips and medicine drips, where the diagnoses are so long that they make your head swim, and the prognoses are so short that they make your eyes overflow. Someone's mother, someone's father, someone's grandma whispers, how long? Maybe it's treatable. Maybe it's only manageable, maybe even terminal. But they beg to know, how long, O Lord? Are we there yet? How long, O Lord? That question rattles throughout the whole creation. The whole creation has been groaning in the pains of childbirth right up till now, right up till the present time. There are floods, and famines, and earthquakes, pandemics, storms, catastrophes, scandals, crises, genocides, holocausts, injustices. They're all crying out, how long, O Lord? That question rattles throughout our whole history. Hundreds of psalmists and prophets and apostles and reformers have spilled gallons of ink and tears to safeguard the message, to safeguard the promise for another generation. Thousands of martyrs have given their witness and their lives. Myriad of saints have endured prosecution. And millions of Christians have fallen asleep, patiently waiting. How long, O Lord? How long? Is that what you're asking? Are we there yet? Are you asking, how long, O Lord? How long? Or have you given up? Have we let go of our hope and laid down our faith? Well, even if we're not asking, how long, O Lord, how long? Our pain is asking. Our needs are asking. Our conscience is asking. The ones hurt by our actions and our attacks and our abuses and our attitudes are asking, how long, O Lord? How long? And God is listening. So, this Ascension Day, it's time for us Christians to ask, how long, O Lord? How long? And the answer we hear is, it won't be long. So let's acknowledge that we won't be here much longer. Let's accept that there's some place better than here. Some place better than this. Someone better than us. Let's admit that we cannot stay like this. We must not stay like this. Let's ask, are we there yet? Let's ask out of repentance. Let's ask in faith and hope of what God will make us and about and of God, where God will take us. It won't be long now. Jesus taught his disciples, and by extension us, in my Father's house are many rooms, and I am going there to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come back to take you to be where I am. And so the angels told the apostles at the Ascension, this same Jesus who has been taken from you into heaven will come back in the same way you saw him go into heaven. It won't be long now. God has entered into our world and edited our story with the incarnated flesh of his Son. God has begun to reveal his strength. He's brought relief for human suffering in the compassion of Jesus' miracles. God has taken our sentence of death and endured what our sins deserve in the crucifixion of Jesus on the cross of Calvary. God has emasculated the devil and emancipated his creation in the resurrection of his Son Jesus from the grave. We've been rescued. We've been forgiven. We've been delivered. We've been saved. We've been redeemed. We've been adopted. And the Holy Spirit has arrived. Arrived to stay. The Christian church has survived. Survived to this very day. And it won't be long now. God is speaking promises of healing. Promises of hope, promises of heaven to troubled minds from his word and in sermons and in songs. God is making children of men into children of God through the gift of holy baptism. God is meeting with his sinful people in the body and blood of his Son in holy communion. God is comforting broken hearts with the reassurances of the resurrection at funeral services. God is touching aching bodies and ailing spirits by the visitation of his people and intercessors. God is providing for empty pockets through the generosity and charity and sacrifices of his humble and anonymous saints. Therefore, that lonely person can get up and leave behind their despair, because it won't be long. The loved one in the hospital can be at peace, because it won't be long now. It won't be long now until the Lord, who has begun this good work in us, will bring it to completion in the day of our Lord Jesus Christ, who will come back in the same way we have seen him go into heaven. Come, Lord Jesus, come quickly. In his holy name, amen. Let's join together as we confess our common faith in the triune God and Holy Spirit who has been given to us in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We now come to that time in our service where we take our cares and our concerns to the Lord in prayer.
Sorry.
Let us pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we pray that you would grant us all things in Christ, so that we might be sustained in trials, strengthened in weakness, and delivered from trouble. That your church may flourish, and that the good news of Jesus Christ, crucified, risen, and ascended, would be proclaimed to the very ends of the earth. We especially ask that you would lead our congregation, Redeemer Lutheran Church, and also our sister congregation, Bethlehem in Fort Wayne, to be bold in our proclamations of your saving grace and mercy. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for the lonely who suffer the burdens of life without friendships or family, for those who are depressed or weary of pandemic measures, and for the fellowship of the church, that we might bear one another's burdens and live in community with Jesus as our head. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, we pray for those who are sick and those who suffer, especially our friends Charlotte Bryant, Tom Eggold, Ren Frank, George Jones, Phil Koshua, Karen Krieger, Eric Schumacher, Trish Wood, Missy Warden, Deb and Darlene Wiley, Donna Harper, and Dora's friend Jeff, who has cancer and one who is in a terrible accident. For Nate's elder cousin in Evansville, and Martha Granger, and for Tommy Maybaugh, and we pray for peace and wisdom for Dan and Amy, and for Ron Jones' sister-in-law, who lost her mother to COVID-19. Give us a spirit of courage as we proclaim you as our risen Lord, and grant healing to our friends' bodies, healing to their minds, consolation in their sorrows. We also give you thanks this morning, Father, for the healing that you gave to Monabel Terrell, who's 95 years old and is now recovering from COVID-19. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Tender Father, we pray for the families of our congregation and community, especially in this time of togetherness, that you would give us forgiving and loving hearts for one another, that we might treat one another with respect and kindness. We also lift up those who are celebrating birthdays in the coming week: Tommy Maybaugh, Amy Wren, and Aubrey Till. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious God, protect the armed forces of this country as they protect our nation from those who would harm us. And on this Memorial Day weekend, we especially give you thanks for those who have given their lives in service to our nation, sacrificing themselves for our well-being. If it be your will, grant peace among all nations. Give your spirit of encouragement and strength to all who put the good of others before themselves. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we lift up our sister congregation Bethlehem as they search for the new pastor to lead their congregation. We pray that your Holy Spirit would guide them and lead them to the man that you have chosen to be with them, to be their shepherd. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of hope, be with those who grieve the loss of a loved one, especially the families of George Shramovich and Louise Gibson, who is the mother-in-law of Bobby Jones. Point them to the promise of the resurrection and the gift of everlasting life to all who die in Christ. Deliver us from distractions, that we may focus on your word, and so that we might be found faithful when Jesus comes again in glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Giving Lord, we pray for our food pantry distribution this week. Use us, your people, to proclaim your love and mercy. May we be living examples of your children living in Easter joy and peace. And may those who come experience your love and your kindness. Lord, in your mercy, into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who also taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now, my dear friends, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you with his favor and fill you with his peace, both today and tomorrow and into eternity. And all God's people said,
amen.
Amen. Thank you for being with us today as we celebrate the Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ. Today I'm excited as we have some virtual fellowship opportunities coming up. We're going to wait for about 10 minutes after we sign off, and then Amanda Grau and Kirk and Megan Randolph and Chris and Marcia Herman and Terry and myself are going to host 4 virtual fellowship rooms, and those are just an opportunity for us to get together, to see one another, to say hi to one another, and just touch bases. No agendas, just a time for fellowship. So I hope that you're able to join us. I sent those links out yesterday by Flock Notes, so everyone should have them in their email. And I sent the link out to download the Zoom app on Friday, so hopefully you've had a chance to do that. As always, you can mail your gifts and offerings to the church. Ellen and I are at Redeemer on Mondays and Wednesdays, although we won't be there on Memorial Day this week. We take care of the mail and we keep the home fires burning. You can also come in for communion on one of those days if you'd like. Please call ahead to make sure that I am with you. You can direct your gifts and offerings to Redeemer also through PayPal on our Facebook page, and the link is at the top of the page. The Lord called our brother George Shramovich to his side on Friday morning. There will be a family graveside service in the coming weeks and days, and a memorial service at a later date when more of the restrictions have been lifted. We give our condolences and our love to Carol and Susan and Kevin and the rest of their families as we celebrate George's life and the blessing he's been to all of us. Our Zoom Bible study will continue this week on Wednesday. If you would like the link, please send me a text or an email. We continue in our study of the book of Deuteronomy. Okay, our Zoom fellowship opportunities will begin in about 10 minutes. Take a opportunity to go grab a cup of coffee or tend to any needs, and then jump into one of the fellowship rooms. I sent the links out yesterday, as I mentioned earlier, so that you should have them. A blessed Memorial Day to all of you. May you have some good times as we are some. May you remember those who have served our country. Terry and I were able to go to the cemeteries yesterday with our family as we remembered our loved ones and relatives who have served and fought and died, and we were blessed to have that opportunity. So I leave you with our closing hymn, which looks like I erased. So let me see if I can find that, which is, okay, here. Which is God Bless America. And that'll be coming up right now. This is probably the one that had the ad on it.
Liberty Mutual, take 96.
Liberty Mutual.
Cut.
A Liberty Mutual.
Cut.
Are you going to charge Liberty Mutual?
All right. God bless America. We'll see you in about 10 minutes. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans, white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless you. What did I do here? I think I might have cut us off before that. There it is.
No, it takes that long. So you're not recording.